Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about partitioning Postgres tables by timestamp-based UUIDs. We're also going to talk about the status of UUID v7 in the current Postgres development branch. To start with, this is a forum post by Chris O'Brien on the Elixir forum. I'll prefix this by saying I'm not familiar with Elixir personally, but I found this post quite insightful, and we're going to take a look at an example that doesn't require Elixir at all. But to start with, what Chris describes here in this post is an approach how to partition a table by a UUID. UUIDs are essentially timestamp-based UUIDs that are encoded slightly differently for display purposes. But for now, we'll assume it's essentially like a UUID that has a timestamp in front. Chris has an application where they're doing a lot of lookups based on the ID column. Now, oftentimes in Postgres, best practice is to do partitioning. If you have a bunch of data, it's more efficient to use a partition table than to keep everything in one big table. Smaller tables are faster to do lookups on, vacuum is going to run faster, and so in general, small tables is good. They wanted to speed it up by partitioning the table based on the insertion time of the record. This can make a lot of sense. For example, if you know that most of your users are accessing recent data and that old data is usually only accessed for archiving purposes, then you could imagine that partitioning your table based on the insertion time and then assuming that the most recent partition is going to be in cache, that makes a lot of sense. But the problem here is that if you want to have an ID column that's still unique, and for example, you use random UUIDs, then you wouldn't actually be able to guarantee uniqueness across the different partitions, assuming you do time-based partitioning on the insertion time, because Postgres does not let you create globally unique indexes. And this is a documented limitation of Postgres, very intentional. There are projects that try to add this, but it's kind of complicated. This is not something that we'll see, I would say, in the near future. Now, the other thing that Chris mentions here is without having a globally unique index, he was worried that queries for a particular ID would have to check every partition. And of course, if you create indexes, it's going to be fast. But the problem is that you can't make use of Postgres's partition pruning because you will have to look at every partition and every index and ask the index in each of these partitions if the ID is present in that partition. The idea here in this post, and this is quite neat, is that he's going to partition the tables based on the timestamp component of the UUID. Each UUID that you're generating or each UUID of a timestamp component you're generating is still unique globally, but then you have a timestamp component that means it sorts based on that timestamp. And so we can actually have daily partitions that belong to a certain set of UUIDs. If you're using Elixir, I would recommend taking a look at the rest of Chris's post, which describes in detail how to set up the migrations in Elixir and how to create the daily partitions automatically. And again, this is using UUIDs. Now, I think what's actually more actionable for many of you is to look at this from a SQL level, because you could use this technique in Rails, Django, or other frameworks as well. All you need to have is a timestamp prefix UUID or UUID. Before we take a look at an example of how this can work, I wanted to use this opportunity to take a look at the status of the UUID v7 work. Let's quickly recap what UUID v7 is. These are essential UUIDs that have a timestamp component in front of them, which really is the core feature that we need for both index performance, but then also to make use of the partitioning we're discussing here. This is still a draft. As of November, that new UUID standard is actually in the process of being published. There's a good chance, if we're looking at the current queue, it's been in here for a little bit under 2 months. And currently they're saying, how long does it take for these documents to become an RFC? And they say 1 to 2 months. And so I think we're actually right at the time where this new standard may become official very soon. Now, on the Postgres side, there has been an effort to add the UUID v7 support into Postgres. Part of the reason why this didn't land in Postgres 16 is because it's still a draft that's being worked on, but we'll actually have a good chance that this patch lands in Postgres 17. I wanted to test the patch here in this thread. Looking back at the history from earlier this week, there's a patch which is still being discussed and there's a bunch of feedback. The names are still going to change, but I just want to try this out and see how this could work. What I did is, locally, I pulled down the latest Postgres development branch, totally experimental. Don't do this at home for any production use, but I would encourage you to engage with the community on testing patches like this. And so what I did is I downloaded the patch from the mailing list. I applied this locally to my local development version with the patch utility, and then I built Postgres, and then I connected to it. What we have here is a fresh Postgres 17 development branch with that UUID v7 patch that's still being discussed. And so what I want to show you now is what Chris implemented on the Elixir forum with a UUID generated on the client side, but this time with the UUID v7 support that's being discussed in Postgres totally on the Postgres side without any client-side support being needed. And you could achieve the same outcome, by the way, with some of the UUID v7 extensions that exist for Postgres today. This does not necessarily mean you have to wait for Postgres 17 or 18 potentially to get this support, but I think this shows how convenient this will be in the future. First of all, we're going to create a table called test. And really the important thing we do here is we make a ID that's UUID, and we make that the primary key. And then we also have some other columns. We're partitioning this table by range, by the ID. You could do this today on any Postgres version, but where it starts being challenging is once you start saying which partitions to create. First, we create an index on that other data field, and now the real magic comes in. What we're doing here is we're creating a table for each day, so a daily partition, and we're using the new gen UUID v7 functions, name may still change, to say from the lowest given possible UUID on this day to the highest possible UUID on this day, these are all the UUIDs that are going to be contained in this day's partition. Now we can do the same for tomorrow. And of course, we could repeat this for many other days. This is the same as regular time-based partitioning. But really what we're doing here is we know that if we generate a random UUID today, it's going to fit into this first partition just by virtue of how UUID v7 works. Now what I can do is I can insert a test value with example 1 as the data. And let's just insert a second one with example 2 as the data. Now, let's suppose we want to search for some of the data. And so if I search for the indexed field, that's not the primary key, but if I just want to search for the data field here, what Postgres will do is it will look at each of the indexes on each of the partitions. We get an append node, and we get a bitmap index scan for both of these indexes on the partition. If I were to search for an ID, on the other hand, what it's able to do is there's no append node because Postgres does partition pruning. And so we know that this UUID value can only ever be in one partition. From a lookup perspective, that's going to be faster. You also have to load less data. And so personally, I could see a big benefit of utilizing this technique when most of the data you're accessing is the data you created recently with recent IDs, because then you can essentially guarantee that that table is going to be kept in cache. And let's imagine you have a bunch of older data. You could then over time repackage that, move it to an archive, but still keep it for lookup. If you have a given ID, you'll be able to know which of the partitions to look for, and that makes all the difference. I'm really excited about this. You could start using this today, as mentioned, but then in Postgres 17, assuming the UUID v7 patch gets committed, this is going to be something you can do built in. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.